今天对我来说是一个很重要的日子，因为如果可以的话，今天我就可以拿得到台湾的身份证。
Hello, this is Keoni Everington from Taiwan News, and our special guest today is Rifat, who is also known by his Taiwanese fans as Wu Feng. He's a TV show host and comedian who's originally from Turkey, but he's lived in Taiwan for 12 years. On Wednesday, he officially received his Taiwanese citizenship. So before we ask you about the process of receiving your Taiwanese citizenship, could you tell us a little bit about yourself?
Yes, I'm here for 12 years. My full name is Ugur Rifat Karlova. I'm from Turkey. Mm. And then I came here with the scholarship of Taiwan. And I studied here. I did my master here. And I started to work in Taiwan and also married in Taiwan. And I have a daughter now, and she is 2.5 years old.
And so was it the scholarship program that brought you to Taiwan to begin with?
The Minister of Education. Because in Turkey, I study Chinese. It was my second university. I studied Chinese. After I finished my school in Turkey, I know that Taiwan Minister of Education of Taiwan are giving scholarships to Turkish students. And then I applied and they gave me. I got the scholarship and I came to Taiwan for further studies.
Mm-hmm. And what interested you in Taiwan? Why Taiwan?
First of all, when I was in Turkey, because of Chinese study, I know that Taiwan has a nice environment, safe. And my some of my teachers, they were from Taiwan. And the dean of my department also studied in Taiwan. So I knew Taiwan is a good place for study. And one of my, in Chinese, they call it xuejie, right? Mm. One of my classmates, like older classmates, she was living in Taiwan for almost 2 years. And she was keep giving me a lot of information about Taiwan and the scholarship, because as a student, we always want to have a scholarship with the good money, good quality of life, and a good education. So I always keep asking questions to her, and she gave me perfect answers. Hmm. And I believe that Taiwan scholarship is the best for my further studies, and so I choose Taiwan.
Now, how about your Mandarin skills? How did you get so good at Mandarin?
I always think that my Chinese is good, but I never say that my Chinese is perfect. Uh-huh. But I entertain people because I used to be a travel guide in Turkey in German and English language. So I always used to speak another languages with the people. So I like to entertain people. So my Chinese skills are good for entertainment business. But I'm not a like translation guide. Some people, they know every proverbs because they got the study of like translation. Mm. They speak more and better Chinese. But my skills for entertainment business, show business, is really good because I like to entertain people. And I like to learn languages and the culture. So whenever I go to any place like Taiwan or any city in Turkey, I like to be the part of that place, like part of Taiwan.
Mm. Now, how about dialects? Can you speak like Taiwanese or Hakka? Or
I just speak a little bit Taiwanese, a little bit like in Taiwan, they call Dambawa. Like, but I always like to learn something new and then share with the people because we are from another countries, because we are Western looking people. Mm-hmm. So in Taiwan, I would like to share from my angle and from my perspective the funny stories to the people. So they like this kind of style. So they accepted me and it's a kind of good thing for me.
So what got you in show business?
Wow. Exactly. It was actually kind of surprising for me. The first thing, I got the job from the state television, Gong Gong Dianshi. When I was walking on the street, one day they said, would you like to be a part of in a documentary? Mm. But at that time I was in Taiwan maybe for a couple of months. Huh. So they came up to me and they asked me the question. I afraid of these people because I don't know if they are going to cheat me or they're going to, you know, I don't know what's going to happen. Maybe they're going to kidnap me. I don't know. And then I asked more questions. They said I can go to the, you know, audition. Mm-hmm. And I accept the audition offer. Uh-huh. And I've been to audition. And then it was a reel. They were doing documentary about Taiwan. Huh. Yeah. And the name of the documentary is Taiwan Rimin Delisha, the history of Taiwan people. Mm-hmm. And I became George Leslie McKay, is a Canadian dentist. The missionary came in Taiwan like 100 years ago. Mm-hmm. So I became that guy because he's also like me, a beard, without hair, bald hair.
Is that right?
Yeah, because we look very similar. You look very similar.
That's how they picked you out on the street.
Yeah. Because in Taiwan, this, you know, they don't have like a lot of like documents or data for the foreigners. So okay. They were looking foreigners on the street, and they found me on the street as a George Leslie McKay. And then I checked the guy's photo. I said, "Oh, it's me," like 100 years ago, because we look very similar.
That's interesting.
It was the first time, and then I liked the environment. It was good to make some money, like dagong, you know, the part-time job. Uh-huh. But the professional, I get in the business because of the also state TV. They were looking a host, because before they were always looking foreigners. But after 2011, they were looking for one host to be part of the show. Okay. And then I became the part of the show for like 3 or 4 months. Mm-hmm. And after that, my show, what I do right now, mm-hmm. I Walker, they offered me a job, the opportunity to become the host of their show. And then I started professionally to do a primetime TV show in Taiwan.
Oh, that's wonderful. Do you have any tips for people interested in getting in the business?
First of all, you need to show yourself. You need to join some communities. For example, I used to do a lot of stand-up comedy. Mm-hmm. At that time, I was always looking for opportunities. For example, they can go to the like audition offices, like agent companies. Mm-hmm. They can start to apply a couple of jobs, so they can try to get close to the environment. They can get close to the show business, and if they have the job, they need to do their best, like entertain people, show your own skills, because we are not coming from Hollywood.
Right.
Yeah, we are not coming from Hollywood. We cannot compare with the Hollywood style of acting or Hollywood style of entertainment, because I'm not a Jimmy Kimmel, right? It's different. It's totally different. It's totally different. So they can create their own style and try to entertain people. Once you entertain people, the show business guys, the managers, or maybe TV station, the owners or the boss, anyone, they notice that you are doing something special, so they can offer you better chances. But it's very, very few, because of the size is very small in Taiwan. We cannot, we don't have like mainland China, we don't have like very like America. Mm-hmm. We have very few chances. I mean, they need to sacrifice many things, because I spend a lot of times, like maybe seven years to have a like hosting opportunity in Taiwan television. 7 years, it's not easy.
Now, you did stand up as well.
I did.
Do you think you could do a little like example of a joke?
Sure.
There's just one joke that you do.
I can do it in Chinese, then we can translate in English.
All right.
Because, I mean, as I said, it's in your country is different style. In my country is different style, and in Taiwan, in Chinese society, is different style. Uh-huh. So I always tell a story, a joke, in front of the audience, and they like it. 有一天，我跟我女朋友在一起，差不多我跟她在一起6个月，过了6个月之后呢，我女朋友说，吴峰，我要跟你分手了。我跟她说，可是为什么？因为什么你要跟我分手呢？ 他说，因为你是外国人。我跟他说，我知道我是外国人，但是6个月之前你没有发现的吗？ I don't know. I mean, you can translate.
Yeah.
Well, I had a girlfriend, a Taiwanese girlfriend, and we dated for 6 months. But after 6 months, she said, I want to break up.
Yeah.
And he said, why? Why do you want to break up? And she said, because you're a foreigner. And he said, didn't you notice that when we first started dating? So that's, I guess it's a kind of a little bit of a difference, maybe too.
But actually, this is a real story.
Oh, really?
Yeah, this is a real story. I mean, I tell the stories actually from all my own life, from all my own stories, own experiences, and I put some humor inside and share the story with the people. So the people like it in a life, because they think that it's real and it's close to their life. And maybe they cannot notice it, but once I share with the people, they like it, because they said, oh yes, they're foreigners in Taiwan, just like a Yangtze. It's like that. I know that. That's kind of stories.
Uh-huh. Yeah, people can relate to it, and some people might have experienced that.
Yeah.
and feel that it comes from maybe their own personal like pain or you know, like unpleasant things that happened to them in the past. Or
because we are in Taiwan, like show business, as a foreigner, starts very, very new. Mm-hmm. In the United States, 100 years ago, they were shooting movies. Mm-hmm. They had stand-up comedy. I mean, at that time, they have different style of comedy. But after 100 years ago, now we have like very rich comedy culture in the United States. Mm-hmm. But in Taiwan, I'm just the starter of this show because I'm the first and the only foreigner in Chinese-speaking society to do this kind of professional style shows. That's why we need time, we need to invest, we need more other foreigners. Otherwise, just me alone, I cannot make like 100 years jump. It's different. So maybe 100 years ago or maybe 50 years ago, when you look at the past, you can see that my shows were very normal. Mm-hmm. But it's very, I mean, it's a procedure. Mm-hmm. It's a kind of development. So I started it. I hope the other foreigners comes and they can develop. And maybe 20 years later, we can have better and richer showbiz in Taiwan.
Yes, that would be great.
Yeah,
be great.
Hope
now,
so.
Yes. We're talking about dating. How did you meet your wife?
Actually, I was in a meeting with a kind of dinner, and she was also in that dinner with other friends. And one of my friends also, they know her, and we were like a kind of friends gathering, right? We were eating, like chatting, talking. I saw her, and she's very beautiful, and I liked her like smile and the attitude. And then at that day, we met each other, like a little bit talking, chatting, switched the phones, the numbers. Sure. And then I started to ask her to go out, eat some food, talk more, and then we started the dating. I mean, the procedure is always like this, like go out, buy something for her. A couple of weeks later, we started to, we became a couple, like a girl and boyfriend. Mm-hmm. And then 2.5 years later, we decided to marry.
Ah. Now, did you get married in Taiwan and Turkey? Did you marriage in both places or just in Taiwan? Or
actually, I married in Taiwan first, but I also did, the procedure, the signing the papers. Mm-hmm. I also did in Turkey, mm-hmm. but I never did a marriage, kind of wedding in Turkey, mm-hmm. ceremony. I didn't because my family is very old. My father is very old, and I don't want to spend a lot of pressure and a lot of time for wedding, because if I spend that time, all my family members, they're gonna be very exhausted. I did in Taiwan the big wedding, mm-hmm. and then in Turkey I did a very small family gathering.
Now getting to the citizenship piece,
yes.
it's difficult for foreigners to get citizenship without having to relinquish their own original passport. So how were you able to do that? How did that work for you?
Actually, before 2016, we couldn't make it because this is actually a law that already fixed. And before this law, we couldn't make it because you need to quit your own citizenship, own country's passport. Mm-hmm. But after the law, when they fixed the law, they put a kind of sentence. They say that the people, the foreigners who live in Taiwan with a professional background in some field, who contribute to the society, they can apply to the Taiwan citizenship and they don't need to quit their own citizenship. Mm. So most of the people, actually, even Taiwanese people and the foreigners, they don't know. Mm. They think that I'm here for 12 years, I married a Taiwanese girl, so I can get the ID. But it's not that, because you need to do contribution and you need to stay here. And Neijinbu, the two units, Neijinbu and the, what is it? Wenhuabu has to accept your application.
Mm-hmm. Ministry of Interior, maybe?
Kind of. Ministry of Interior and then the
Cultural.
Because
office.
My part, because my field, I'm doing for entertainment and the culture part. So I can apply that field, but I cannot apply for technology. Mm-hmm. Every field has different items. For example, I don't know the others, but in my part, it was like getting an award. Because if you don't have any award from the country, it's a bit hard to apply. This is the first item. And the second item, they check what kind of things you did for Taiwan. For example, I wrote 3 books in Taiwan and 1 book in Turkey. It was about the modern history of China. And I was the ambassador of Taiwan technology products in Turkey. And I was always in Turkish television promoting Taiwan's technology to the Turkish audiences, like CNN Turk, all the other Turkish famous TV stations. I was inside for the special programs for introducing Taiwan's products. Also, I'm doing TV hosting and then including cultural things. I've been to all the temples, always promoting Taiwan's culture to the people. And also our show is very famous in Malaysia and also in Singapore. These things also helped me. Also like stage, what you already mentioned. Mm-hmm. I did stage shows. I created the stand-up comedy in Chinese. Mm-hmm. I did the Minister of Defense theater. I mean, many stuff plus my education. And then my wife, 2 years ago, she started to collect all my papers one by one. She asked everyone for the information because it's a long procedure. Uh-huh. It's not like, oh, okay, I'm married, I have these kind of things, and I'm applied today. It's not that. You need to collect all the papers. Like the photos must be special. Everything, the details must be on the papers. Mm-hmm. And then you apply. But once you apply, you need to wait for the procedure because Nejumbu, right, the Ministry of, Interior, something. Yeah, the first unit says, okay, and then the Minister of Culture, they need to also accept it. Otherwise, you cannot get it. Huh. So two different government organizations, they have to say, okay, then you can get the citizenship and you don't need to quit. Yes, wow. Kind of hard.
You did it. Now, how do you feel? How do you feel that you're
I'm
able
so
to?
I'm so happy first. Yeah. And I kind of feel like relaxed because, I mean, getting Taiwan ID kind of make me the part of Taiwan because I really love this place. I try to do good things for Taiwan society. I try to build better things for the Taiwan. Mm-hmm. And once I get the citizenship, I feel myself like, okay, now officially I'm part of Taiwan and I can vote. I can talk more. Mm-hmm. Because before you want to say something maybe about country's future, about the system, they always say, Anissa Weigoren, you're a foreigner, you don't need to say that. Mm-hmm. But now, as a foreigner, I can be the part of government because I have that right. Mm-hmm. So I can join the government, I can go to vote, I can be, I mean, maybe like Li Fa-yuan, you know, I...
Oh, yeah, you could run for office.
I can run for office, anything. Uh-huh. So I can do more stuff for the government. Mm-hmm. And plus, my wife is from Taiwan. My daughter also has double citizenship from Turkey and Taiwan. Sometimes when we go to Europe, I'm from Turkey, I don't have visa. Hmm. I need to apply a visa and I need to spend a lot of money. Hmm. So my wife and my daughter can go that country, but I cannot go. So I need to ask for visa, but I cannot get in that country. It's a big problem. Huh. So now I have a Taiwan ID, a Taiwan passport. Hmm. So I don't need to ask. I don't need to ask all the time. I don't apply the visas all the time.
Ah, so you can go all the places that Taiwanese people can go, basically.
Yeah, I can go. Great. For example, in 2 weeks, I'm going to go to New Zealand. Mm-hmm. For example, if I go with the Turkish passport, I need to have a visa. So if I need to take visa, I need to apply, I need to spend money, I need to wait. Mm-hmm. It's a bit mafan, you know?
Right.
Yeah. So that's why I'm going to use my Taiwan passport so I can go and come to Taiwan easily. It's much better for me.
Any new projects that are coming up in the future?
First of all, I would like to introduce more about my country, mm-hmm. like Turkey, because in 2018, in mainland China, is the tourism year of Turkey. Oh. I think it's a good opportunity for me to introduce more about my country's tourism, mm-hmm. and my country's beauty, the history to the people. Mm-hmm. I mean, I really want to get more opportunities from that organization, from that, from that event. Uh-huh. And then I'm going to continue to do more TV shows. And I'm going to, in these days, I'm creating more YouTube things, like online videos. Mm-hmm. And these kind of things, I think I need to do more. Mm-hmm. I'm going to do these kind of things more. And then the rest, after I... spent a couple of months later, I want to go to Turkey for a little bit holiday. I want to stay in Turkey a bit longer because I want my daughter learns a bit more Turkish.
Ah, yes.
Yeah.
That would be good.
Because in entertainment business, you cannot make a lot of plans. You never know what's going to happen next. Mm. So, but this year I want to go to the Turkish event and then my own TV show, more internet shows. And I hope after I get my Taiwan ID, I hope more TV shows give me offer as a host. Because always they think that I live a lot. Why Gordon, your Chinese skills, I mean, it's different. I can't speak like my mother tongue. It's different. Uh-huh. But I want to be part of the TV business more than before.
That's great.
Well, thank you so much for coming on our show.
Thank you very much for the invitation. I really appreciate it. Thank you. And share my story with the people. I hope everybody knows it. And they keep sending a lot of mails to me and to my wife. And please, the procedure is tough. And it's not that I'm here as a foreigner for 5 years and I'm going to get it. I hope more people get it. Maybe one day the law changes again. Yeah, maybe so they can make hopefully. It more relaxing mm-hmm. and more foreign friends can apply. But now the procedure is pretty tough. They need to consider.
Thank you very much, Rifat, for coming to our show.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
Thank you for watching Taiwan News, and we'll see you next time.